This world is a vibrant life sphere, filled with diverse people spread across every corner of the globe, each speaking their own unique languages and sharing their distinct cultures. When they're trying to collaborate, they can't understand each other. And Translator bridges communication between people from different countries. That's exactly what in the digital world. Programming languages are the universal translators between humans and machines. Machines don't understand human speech, they only understand binary ones and zeros. We use programming languages to bridge that gap, just like a translator. A chef uses recipes and a musician uses sheet music. Each profession has its own language to represent ideas. Similarly, PLC programming languages allows engineers to talk to machines and create automated processes. Without them, modern manufacturing, packaging, and even transportation systems wouldn't function. Welcome back to Mr. Smart. In today's video, we are going to dive into the world of PLC programming languages. International Electrotechnical Commission, or IEC, created the global standard for PLC programming, known as IEC 61131-3. This standard defines the five main programming languages used in automation today, each with unique strengths. Just like spoken languages, some are simpler for beginners, while others offer more flexibility and power. Let's explore each one. Ladder diagram or ladder logic is the most popular PLC programming language and has its roots in electrical engineering. It visually resembles a ladder with rungs that represent logical operations. Each rung describes a control process, like turning on a motor when a switch is pressed. It's intuitive for electricians and technicians because it mimics the layout of physical relay circuits. Ladder logic is excellent for discrete control systems such as start-stop operations, alarms, and interlocks. Function block diagram, or FBD, uses graphical blocks to represent different functions like timers, counters, and logic gates. Each block has inputs and outputs that connect to other blocks, creating a flow of information. FBD is particularly useful for engineers who think visually, as it's easier to see the overall process at a glance. It's ideal for complex control systems like PID controllers, signal processing, and batch processes in industries. Structured text is a high-level programming language that feels like traditional coding in Python, C, or Java. It uses structured commands to create logical operations, loops, and calculations. With its ability to handle complex data, it's perfect for tasks like advanced mathematical operations, data logging, and communicating with external systems. While it requires a stronger programming background, its power and versatility make it a favorite for seasoned programmers and engineers. Instruction list is a low-level, text-based language that uses simple, compact commands to control operations. It's similar to assembly language in traditional programming. While IL is not as user-friendly as other languages, its concise nature makes it efficient for systems with limited memory or processing power. Though less commonly used today, IL can still be valuable for troubleshooting legacy systems or creating highly optimized code. Sequential function chart is like a flowchart for automation. It breaks down processes into individual steps, with transitions defining when to move to the next step. This makes it ideal for sequential tasks like manufacturing process with multiple stages. It's perfect for applications requiring precise task management and timing, like robotics or batch processing. Choosing a PLC programming language depends on your specific application and comfort level. If you're just starting out, ladder logic is beginner-friendly. For visual learners, function block diagram or sequential function chart are great options. Structured text offers unparalleled power for advanced programming, while instruction list provides a compact alternative for resource-limited systems. Understanding their strengths will help you pick the best tool for the job. That's all for today's video. It's just an introduction, and stay connected for deep dives into each PLC programming language and more exciting automation topics. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to support our channel. See you in the next video.